That uses a chord-based, play first, ask questions later, approach that gets you sounding like a pro right away. Creator Robin Hall says that his ebook course will teach you to play piano by ear, improvise, create compositions, and then eventually read piano sheet music, with each bite-sized lesson planned to move you from one skill to the next in a short period of time in a logical way. According to testimonials, 20 to 30 minutes of daily practice can be all it takes to start sounding good within a few days. So, how does Pianoforall work? Can it live up to its claims? Keep reading, I'll cover everything you need to know to decide whether or not Pianoforall is the course for you. What you'll need. Pianoforall is quite flexible in terms of what you'll need to use the course, but a piano or keyboard is obviously non-negotiable. It's much better to get a 61-key keyboard and start practicing than to not have a keyboard at all. However, I'd still recommend upgrading to an 88-key digital piano with fully weighted keys as soon as possible if you're serious about learning the piano. Most 61-key keyboards are unweighted or semi-weighted, which means they feel much lighter and very different from an acoustic piano keyboard. Digital pianos, on the other hand, usually have 88 hammer action keys that try to replicate the feel of an acoustic piano as closely as possible, which helps develop proper finger strength and technique. What's included? With your one-time purchase of the course, you'll receive 9 ebooks plus 1 bonus book. These comprehensive ebooks take you through various styles of piano music with chords, tunes, and exercises, teaching you just enough theory for each lesson. I'll go into detail on each book below. 200 video lessons, embedded in the ebook itself. These videos reinforce skills with explained keyboard demonstrations by Robin Hall. He plays the lesson on a lower keyboard while an animated keyboard above shows you which notes he is playing, making it clear which notes you should play, what your hands should look like, and how it should sound. 500 audio tunes and exercises. These are beside each exercise to show you quickly what it should sound like. Auditory learners especially will benefit from hearing each exercise before attempting it. The curriculum. Each ebook covers a different aspect of piano playing and builds on one another so that you are putting the skills you've learned into practice. Except for book 9, which can be used at any time, you should read the books in order. Book 1, Party Time, Rhythm. Style Piano. The first book is an introduction to both the program and the keyboard. It begins by stating the primary principle of Pianoforall, that it's important to lay a foundation of chords and rhythms before building improv, melody composition, and sight reading skills beyond that. It introduces you to the notes on the keyboard and then jumps immediately into playing some basic 3-note chords, reminded you that like learning guitar, it's more important to play than to worry about the theory at this early stage. Book 1 also introduces musical notation, including rests and basic rhythm. While most traditional curriculums spend a while on note naming and rhythm exercises, this section moves quickly. You'll likely need to keep revisiting it to make sense of later exercises. The rest of the book progresses by teaching you a family of chords and introducing a rhythm associated with popular music, which you can use with the chords to play a song. Pros and cons. Now let's sum up some of the pros and cons of the Pianoforall teaching course. Visual and auditory lessons. Unlike classic ebooks and printed curricula, Pianoforall provides you with visual and auditory ways to learn the content, which is especially helpful for learned into practice. Practice. Except for book 9, which can be used at any time, you should read the books in order. Book 1, Party Time, Rhythm. Style Piano. The first book is an introduction to both the program and the keyboard. It begins by stating the primary principle of Pianoforall, that it's important to lay a foundation of chords and rhythms before building improv, melody composition, and sight reading skills beyond that. It introduces you to the notes on the keyboard and then jumps immediately into playing some basic three-note chords, reminded you that like learning guitar, it's more important to play than to worry about the theory at this early stage. Book 1 also introduces musical notation, including rests and basic rhythm. While most traditional curriculums spend a while on note naming and rhythm exercises, this section moves quickly. You'll likely need to keep revisiting it to make sense of later exercises. The rest of the book progresses by teaching you a family of chords and introducing a rhythm associated with popular music, which you can use with the chords to play a song. Pros and cons. Now let's sum up some of the pros and cons of the Pianoforall teaching course. Visual and auditory lessons. Unlike classic ebooks and printed curricula, Pianoforall provides you with visual and auditory ways to learn the content, which is especially helpful for beginners who aren't yet comfortable reading music. Having the videos and audio clips embedded in the ebooks makes it super easy to access this content when you need it. Jumps right into playing. You'll feel like you're making progress from the first session. Uses well-known songs. Not only does this make it easier to play by ear, you'll enjoy being able to play songs that you recognize. Promotes musicality. Playing by ear, improvising, and composing melodies are often mostly ignored in piano methods for beginners. Pianoforall teaches these skills thoroughly, giving you a solid base of musicality and ensuring that you'll always have something to play. Makes you use your left hand more than traditional piano curriculums. As is the case for many piano players who take the traditional approach, I was accustomed to focusing on the right hand. As my pieces got more complex, I had to devote a lot of time to practicing the left hand parts alone. Since Pianoforall encourages you to practice more with the left hand than the right, students of this program will be less likely to have a lazy left hand. Information is laid out clearly and easy to understand. While a bit plain compared to printed curriculum like Faber's Piano Adventures, these ebooks are well organized and visually clean. Cons. Little focus on technique. Traditional piano teachers remind their students of their hand position, posture, and their wrist, finger, and body movements. While lack of this teaching is an obvious drawback of online piano courses in general, Pianoforall in particular does not address it. I recommend supplementing the course with lessons, YouTube counts, that teach posture and other techniques. Avoids reading music. Even in the books that rely more heavily on sheet music, the names of the notes are usually provided, and sometimes you're given the option to improvise. Therefore, even though one of the goals of the course is to teach you how to read music, it would be easy to come out with a less than stellar grasp of this skill. Leaves out many piano notation symbols and terms. While the amount of terms and symbols this curriculum covers is adequate for those who want to improvise, play by ear, or play basic sheet music, students wanting to go beyond may find themselves perplexed by unknown markings. If you're one such student, Hall recommends supplementing his course with material that teaches the terms and symbols of music notation. Please comment and share this video if you like it.